if you are familiar with my work, you'll know that I do a fair amount of political comedy, which is not the most constructive hobby to have in India. But I do it, it's fun. But this also means that I get a fair amount of death threats, right? And some of them very cute. Like I... No, genuinely, it's entertaining at times. And I got this very interesting death threat sometime last year. Well, first of all, I got the threat at 7 in the morning. And I was like, who wakes up at 7 a.m.? And their first thought of the day is, aaj Azim ko marna hai. No, most people, they'll wake up, they'll get out of bed, you know, have a cup of tea, read the newspaper, go to the bathroom. Not this guy. You know, this guy's jumped out of bed straight. He has morning wood. And he's thinking of me. Which I take as a compliment, honestly. At least someone's thinking of me. But then his amazing death threat was as follows. He was like, bro, which is an endearing way to start any threat. He said, bro, agar phir se PM ke baare mein joke mara na, to mujhse bura koi nahi hoga. Didn't finish that. Dot, dot, dot. Shayad. Shayad? What kind of low confidence murderer are we dealing with here? Mujhse bura koi nahi hoga? Shayad. What does he think? Like, why? It's like he was having an existential crisis while writing this message. He's typing it out. Mujhse bura koi nahi hoga. Then he had a flashback to his childhood. About how his parents always loved his younger brother more. Single tear rolls down his cheek. Shayad. I don't understand. How can you be a criminal and have low confidence? That's like Vijay Mallya calling himself the king of reasonably good times. Mujhse bura koi nahi hoga? Shayad. What does he think is going to happen, right? He'll show up at my show, stand up from a corner, point a gun, say, fucka, I'll kill you. From the other side, one rival gunman stands up. Like, buddy, I will kill you and your family. This guy is like, fuck, yaar. Sala, hamesha mere se koi bura nikalta. He gets upset, goes home, can't sleep. You know, he's lying in bed, staring at the ceiling, watching the fan go round and round. Clock is ticking away. Suddenly, it's 7 a.m. Alarm rings. It's like, here we go again. Finds a new comedian. He's like, death threat's clearly not working. Let's change the game. It is like, bro. Agar phir se PM ke baare mein joke mara na, to I will fuck your sister. Dot, dot, dot. If she is okay with it. Single tear. Because he's a virgin. But you know, this entire death threat scene got me very fascinated overall with the idea of death. You know, I started reading up a lot about the death penalty in India because I feel it's good information to have as a Muslim person with anti-establishment views. It's nice to know the ways in which you can die by mistake, right? And I was looking at the various crimes for which you can get the death penalty in India. There's the obvious ones, of course, murder, rape, kidnapping. Kidnapping, though multiple offenses, first one free, try it out. My favorite death penalty crime in India, this is 100% true, you can look it up. There is, in India, there is death penalty for dacoity with 5 members or more. Specifically 5 or more. What is this Uber Go method of justice? How do they reach this conclusion? They're having a meeting, sir, these dacoits, they've become a big menace, sir. Should we kill all of them? No. Only those with 4 or more friends. They think they can be criminals and have a happening social life. Who even uses the word dacoit anymore? Have you ever seen a policeman? Are you a dacoit? No, sir, I'm bandit actually. Okay, okay, jaane do, jaane do. We're only looking for dacoits today. We got lucky. I feel so bad for the dacoits, dude. Because all their social activities now, because of this law, are limited to just 4 people. Like, they're not even gangs anymore. Now they're just PUBG clans. Roaming the forests of Chambal wearing frying pans on their head. All they can do is just sit and make meme videos. Like, ye hum hai. Ye hamara gang hai. Aur hamari dacoity chal rahi hai. Feel so, like, you think about so many, like, when you think about the movie Sholay, it's actually a documentary. Or should I say a documentary? About dacoits coming to terms with these new rules. Because in Shole, why did Jay and Veeru win? Because kitne aadmi the? Wo do, hum teen. Char se zyada allowed hi nahi. Without this law, Shole would be a very short movie. Kitne aadmi the? Wo do, hum das. Fir kya hua? Gaand maar di. End. Credits rolling, Basanti naach rahe side mein. Like so many epics would not be possible to recreate with this law, right? Alibaba and 40 Thieves. Impressive, right? Ensemble cast. Alibaba and 4 Thieves, fucking street play. Who wants to watch this? You want to watch Alibaba and 4 Thieves? No, I'll watch Alibaba and 4 Gaurakshaks. Way more interesting. Spoiler alert, Gaurakshak wins.